What's up, everybody? Welcome back. My name's Josh, and today we're talking about the crazy real estate market. For anybody that's watched my videos before, you know I invest in real estate and multifamily properties, and it's been a pretty big piece of my investing portfolio for the past 5-6 years. Now, anybody that's aware of what's going on in the industry, prices are really high, and it doesn't look like they're really starting to come down or stagnate at all, at least right now. So, what can I do with the real estate investing money that I wanted to put away? Well, I'm gonna do a video separate of this with a couple of different ways to invest in real estate. Today, I'm specifically talking about something that I have done in the last year, and that's remodeling. As I do with any video, I have to provide the disclaimer: this is not financial advice. I'm not telling you what to do with your money. I'm just explaining what I'm doing with mine right now so I can see a really decent return while the real estate market starts to level out or gets back to normal. For the purposes of today's video, I'm just gonna be talking about one of the properties that I own. It's a triplex, so 3 doors for 1 mortgage. Now, one unit actually got severely damaged, and I actually had to end up remodeling that and adding a little more to just the remodel. I actually had to put in a little extra work in repairing damages. The other unit, the second unit, it was just a normal remodel once my tenant moved out. So, 2 different approaches here. You're gonna hear the actual differences in cost, and then what I'm gonna do is actually break down the return in a year and then total return between both actual, let's call it investments. This technically isn't a traditional investment like the stock market or buying a property, but if you're a real estate investor and you already own property, then this is a way to receive a return. A return is a return on investment, right? So you put money into something and you expect a return. At the end of the day, it doesn't really matter too much where you put that money. It's just as long as you're seeing some kind of return back, getting your money to work for you. Now, the goal of these remodels is obviously to see a return, right? And the easiest way to do that for a rental property is going to be cash flow. So the goal here is to make the unit nicer, newer, more modern, and provide a better place for a tenant to live while also increasing the rent, bring it up to market rent. It's easier to capture a lower rent if a lot of the appliances are older, it looks a little worn, that kind of thing. But once you update everything, then you can actually bring it up to market rent, which is the goal here. Now, why the rents were as low as they were, probably about $300 to $400 under market rent, is I had a couple of really good tenants that had been there for a long time. So a little more of a strategy there. If you've got a great tenant, it's actually a little harder to find a good tenant, especially doing background checks and that kind of thing. And in this COVID environment, it's been even more challenging. If you have a really good tenant, you're probably a little more lax on the 2 to 5% increases in rent and are a little more open to negotiation. Anyways, let's start with the very first unit. The first unit that we had started at about $1,250, so $1,250 in market rent. The market was right around 1500 to, I would say, 1600, 1650 in this area. And that also includes the type of unit it was. These are 2-bedroom, 1.5-bath units. Now, this first unit that I'm talking about was the one that didn't actually have too much damage. So this was much more of a wear and tear situation where you end up replacing the normal stuff anyways, like paint and that kind of thing, cleaning the carpets. But then on top of that, I'm also remodeling it. And what I would focus on for the remodel were things that I think pop up in those pictures when you advertise them and things that the tenants really care about the most. So the high value items. So redoing the bathrooms, redoing the kitchen, that includes the cabinets, the appliances, that kind of thing. And then of course the flooring, I think, is another big piece, whether that's carpet or the vinyl laminate that we got. And a lot of that was done by a contractor. I am not the person to go in and handle that, and that works for certain people. If you want to get in and do your own thing, by all means, tear it up. But I actually, for me, it's more of like a value versus time thing, and it's valuable for me to go ahead and pay somebody to do that if I'm going to see the return in the numbers that I'm getting here. So after I listed out what we actually needed to get done for this very first unit, the estimate actually came in at $18,831.25. the actual, after it was all done, was $14,493.75. The remodel took about a month, so it was actually really quick, and it actually got rented 3 months later. So I only had 3 months of no rent that I had to float for this one particular unit, with all the other units filled. The new rent for this unit, once it was completely remodeled, was $1,600. Now, here are a few pictures of the actual unit. This is technically the second unit we're gonna be talking about, but they're identical in what I did, the materials that I used, and the actual layout here too. So let's go through the actual numbers. If rent is going from $1,250 up to $1,600, and the cost is $14,493.75, that means there is a 28% increase in rent, right? So, and that's gross numbers. And based on the cost and the actual difference between what originally was the rent and the actual increase, I'm gonna take that as the return, that's a 28% return in year one on that $14,000. I don't know about you, but I don't think there's many other things other than cryptocurrency that's gonna give you a return like that. Now, a good reminder here is that this unit I did after the one I'm about to talk about, and so the other one that we did was a little more damaged, a little more expensive, and again, the contractor had to go in there and handle a lot of stuff. It was a little more managed work on that one, and it taught me a lot of what not to do with this one, which is why it was almost $8,000, $9,000 cheaper for this particular unit, which is why we pulled a 28% return on this. So on to unit number two. Unit number two was originally renting for $1,300, about a $50 difference from the first unit. The issue here was that there was water damage, there was other stuff that we had to take care of with the drywall, and a couple of the appliances were actually damaged as well. On top of that, it was right around the time COVID had started, and so the actual materials and getting things that we needed were much more of an issue. So when we started this, it was about January, believe it was January 2020. Yep. And I didn't get a tenant in there until July. So as you could tell, that would be a little bit more of a float for almost 7 months handling that mortgage. Fortunately, you run the numbers conservatively and the other properties are still floating this particular property. Anyways, the expenses for the remodel for unit number two was $22,048.75. So as you can tell, quite a bit more versus the traditional remodel with not any kind of damage. The new rent for this unit was $1,500. That's a $200 difference. So the pros here, while this first remodel that I had done for unit number two ended up only being a 15% increase, that's still quite a bit more than the standard 3-5% increase you would put into your normal rental agreements. Now, where this one starts to hurt is the actual return in year one. So this one with the increase in $200 for year one, so you multiply that out by 12 and divide by the $22,048.75 cost, it's only a 10% return in year one. If you guys do the math, the S&P 500, I think, sits about 13%, and the total stock market sits about 9-ish, maybe a little more. So you're kind of in that area of the stock market and S&P 500 return with realistically a little more risk. Again, still, this is a long-term play, and one important point is a lot of these numbers are taking into consideration the actual return on cash flow, not necessarily capital appreciation, which I believe if I take a look at what the property is worth now, over the last couple of years, it's returned about 16-17%. So what's the total increase across the board for this massive remodel? So rent is up $550, so a 35% increase in rent because of the remodels. Total expenses were $36,542.50, so the total annual rent, $6,600. That's an 18% total return year one. That return does beat the actual stock market and where I have the return. Now, it's a little challenging because the last year has returned more than that, but that's because we had a massive dip, and if you bought in the right time, you'd see those 19, 20, 25% returns. So a couple of things that I really learned from this and reminded me of as a real estate investor. Number one was that cushion that everybody talks about, the 3 to 6 month cushion on floating properties and vacancy rates are so important. I got to use the fund for that, for floating the properties while this was getting remodeled. While the profit from the other doors really did help, at the end of the day, there were a couple of months that I did have to pull into that fund and pay a little bit towards the mortgage. A good reminder of investing is not just that initial down payment and the remodel or any kind of capital expenditures like the HVAC system, but it is also that extra cushion that you need to invest in those properties. Number two goes back to just being creative. It's a good reminder to be creative with your money. When I had sold another property and was looking to sell that single family and get into another multifamily, everything happened with COVID, and it did make the market dip for a little bit, but then it blasted back off into what we are now, and there's a lot more demand than there is supply right now, and we're running into cash offers, at least in my area, cash offers, multiple cash offers, and it's tough to get a property within the cap rate that I normally want and the condition that I normally want. So I really started to explore other ways to make that money work for me instead of leaving it in a 0.5% yielding annual interest account at Ally. And while I did put some of that into the stock market, I did look at the current portfolio that I had and said, hey, what can I do to improve this, make it better for tenants, and also increase rents? And that, of course, is where I ran into the remodel. The last thing that really got me excited about this was I'm just running numbers on the actual income return, so rent, cash flow. And while cash flow is really important, one thing that I think real estate investors, including myself, maybe this is myself that I'm talking about here, is that capital appreciation is something pretty important too, right? The property itself has increased quite a bit, and doing these kind of remodels also add value to the property. That's all I got for you guys today. Thank you for watching. If you got any questions or comments on real estate or the remodel, leave them in the comment section below. If you like this type of content, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button, and don't forget to like the video, because liking really helps get this out to other people interested in this kind of stuff. Hope you guys have a great rest of your Friday. See you later.